You have probably burned biomass in your life for energy supply. Think about lighting a match to ignite your kitchen or camping gas burner. Or what about making your own wood-based campfire? The principle of combustion is the exothermic chemical reaction between oxygen and a fuel source, like wood or alcohol. Heat is thus released. Biomass is composed of mainly cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. These are carbon-based natural biomass polymers, which makes them excellent fuel for combustion. The composition of solid fuels, and thus also biomass, after analysis in a laboratory, can be given on different bases, mostly presented in mass percentages. The first fuel composition basis is the as-received composition, abbreviated as A.R. This means that the fuel is considered with all its constituents, the combustible matter composed of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur and oxygen, the non-combustible matter, also called ash and moisture. A fuel composition description on dry basis considers that all moisture has been evaporated from the fuel. Finally, a fuel composition can be given on a dry and ash-free basis, abbreviated as DAF or DAF. In this case, all non-combustible material, ash and moisture, has been removed and the composition is usually normalized to 100%. One can calculate the composition given on one basis into the other basis. As an example, we first set up an equation that states that the total mass of an element I, for example carbon, on a dry and ash-free basis is equal to the mass of the same element I on an as-received basis. So the mass percentage of the element I times the mass in the dry and ash-free basis is equal to the mass percentage of the element I times the mass in the as-received basis. We can further work this out by dividing the equation by the mass of dry and ash-free matter. Now the mass of dry and ash-free matter is equal to the mass on as-received basis minus mass of ash and mass of moisture, both counted on an as-received basis. Finally, we can divide the numerator and denominator by the total mass of as-received matter. This gives this equation, in which y values are mass fractions on an as-received basis. This forms the basics of performing combustion calculations. One important question to answer in combustion calculation is, how much air is needed for complete combustion of biomass fuel? The fully oxidized product of carbon is carbon dioxide, and that of hydrogen is water. If there is exactly enough oxygen to oxidize all combustible elements, we speak of complete combustion conditions. This is called stoichiometric combustion. The air factor lambda is the ratio of the mass flow of air to the mass flow of fuel divided by the same ratio, but then under conditions of stoichiometric combustion. By definition, lambda equals 1 in stoichiometric combustion. One speaks about fuel lean combustion when more oxygen is available for reaction with the fuel than exactly needed for the stoichiometric combustion of each of the elements binding oxygen in the fuel. The generated combustion product stream is called flue gas. Because there is excess oxygen in the process, this flue gas will then contain oxygen. Fuel-rich combustion takes place when not enough oxygen is available to completely oxidize the fuel elements to their fully oxidized products. In this case, flue gas will contain practically no oxygen. In case lambda is much smaller than 1, this characterizes this process as gasification. The gaseous end products of such process is complex and still contains some chemical energy in molecules like CO, and hydrogen that are not completely oxidized. In combustion calculations, we often assume the air to be composed of 79 volume percentage of nitrogen and 21 volume percentage of oxygen. We can write out the combustion reaction equation, assuming biomass to consist of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen only. 1 mole of CxHyOz reacts with A times lambda, number of moles of air, which is 1 mole of O2 plus 79 over 21 moles of N2. The reaction products then are x moles of CO2, y over 2 moles of water plus A times lambda times 79 over 21 moles of nitrogen, and finally A times lambda minus 1 moles of O2. The stoichiometric factor A can be calculated based on a balance for O atoms, for the case that lambda is 1. This I leave as an exercise for you to perform.